Rear camera that flips, and more than that, an all screen display just like this. No notch, no punch hole or anything like that to disturb the screen. Hey, what's up guys, it's Banu here from AndroDollar.com. This is Samsung's latest Galaxy A80 that has a triple rotatable camera at the back and, like I mentioned, an all screen display. So there's no hindrance at all. So I've actually been using this device for about a month now, and in this video I'm going to be sharing my experience of the A80 with you guys. So if you guys are excited to know all about the Galaxy A80, and if you're new to my channel, definitely go ahead and smash that subscribe button right now. Let's get started with today's video. The most important thing about the Galaxy A80 is the screen that is there at the front. So the screen on the Galaxy A80 is a 6.7 inch Super AMOLED Full HD Plus display, and boy does it look great. We all know that Samsung is on top of its game when it comes to displays, and the A80 is no exception to that. Samsung has somehow managed to take away the notches and the punch holes from the display and hide the front-facing camera in the rotatable screen, as well as all the sensors and the earpiece behind the display of the Galaxy A80. That's right, the earpiece on the A80 is behind the glass right over here. We'll talk more about that in a bit. The result of that is we have a full screen display that looks really great. Now let's talk about the design of the Galaxy A80. The A80 actually has a metallic design, and it's slightly heavier than your average smartphone. The first time I actually got it to my hand, I actually felt like this top part of the phone is quite a bit heavier than the bottom part. So the weight distribution at the top is quite a bit more than the bottom. That's the way I feel about the device. That could be mainly because of all the sensors and all the extra equipment Samsung has to bundle in here at the top for the rotatable camera. However, that isn't a big hindrance. After you get used to the device, it gets quite normal, but definitely the A80 is a heavy device, so keep that in mind if you're planning to pick this one up. One thing good I felt with the weight of the A80 is that I felt like the A80 is quite sturdy. I mean, you can hear the metal. Listen to this. And it looks and feels like quite a sturdy device. The display has rounded corners, which is definitely pleasing to look at, and the bezels of the device are actually quite small. When talking about the design, there's something that we should definitely talk about on the A80, and that is this rotatable camera that is there at the back. Every time the camera comes up and rotates, it makes this sound. Listen to this. Just like that. So the beauty of this rotatable camera is all the three cameras of the smartphone are here. So that means your primary camera is going to be as good as your secondary camera. So that's pretty awesome when you think about it, because in most of the smartphones, even in flagship smartphones, the selfie camera isn't as good as the rear facing camera. So the theory Samsung has gone with here is, what if we reverse the rear camera? So that way, automatically, you have a perfect camera at the front too. We'll talk more about the camera quality of the A80 in a bit, but for now we'll focus about the mechanics of the rotatable camera. I'm pretty sure the question that a lot of you guys have in mind is, how durable will the rotatable camera be on the A80? Actually, Samsung has put it to a lot of good tests, and they are claiming that it is quite durable. But with devices that have a lot of moving components, the probability of this breaking is quite high. That's not something that is only affecting the A80, but it's something that is affecting all the other devices that have the pop-up style cameras as well. If you have an A80 and if every time the camera pops up, you will have to be slightly cautious about the usage, because let's say if a dust particle or if a piece of sand goes inside this device, that might cause harm to your device. That's a little bit of a warning for those of you who are planning to pick the A80 up, but in the time that I used the A80, I actually didn't face any type of issue like that, and the experience has been quite great. I've been using it as one of my primary devices, and the experience was quite okay for me. Sadly, there is no fall detection on the A80, so if you accidentally drop your device, that might not be so good. So be extra careful if you use a A80. Talking about accessories also, you will have to be a bit more careful when you pick accessories, because this has this extra moving component, so you might not be able to find the best accessories for this device really well, so be careful about that too. Even to use this device without any cover, I think would be okay, because the design, like I told before, seems to be quite durable. I have been using it without any case or any tempered glass. So far so good. In the month that I used, I don't see any type of scratches or anything. I think this device will be able to survive with the average type of use. Another important thing when talking about the design of the A80 is that this device doesn't have a headphone jack. So if you're a fan of the headphone jack, RIP headphone jack, we don't have that here anymore. Now that we are talking about the headphone jack, let's go around the device and see what is there on the A80 as well. First off, at the bottom, we have the SIM card tray, a USB type C port, the primary microphone, as well as the speakers. And on the right hand side, we have the power button. And at the top, we have the secondary noise cancellation microphone. And on the left hand side, we have the volume rockers. At the back, we have the triple rear camera, like I mentioned, along with the Samsung logo. And at the front, like I mentioned, there's nothing here other than the grey display. There is also a fingerprint scanner embedded underneath the display here. And the earpiece, like I mentioned before, is at the top, that is underneath the display. So now let's talk about my experience about that, because I've actually been having a little bit of a mixed experience with the in-display earpiece on the A80. The display now uses a piezoelectric speaker that vibrates the entire display to produce sounds for all calls. That's all great in theory, but the sensor is placed somewhere over here. So my natural position for taking calls is this. So because most of the time the earpiece is over here, I'm more used to keeping my phone like this. But with the A80, the experience that I faced was the earpiece was somewhere around here. So what I had to do instead of keeping the phone like this is I actually had to keep the phone like this. So that was not the natural position for me to keep the phone in my ear. But if you're using this smartphone on a regular basis, you're definitely gonna get used to it. The sound coming from this earpiece was quite good, but I actually didn't like the fact that I had to keep the phone like this halfway down. So that was a drawback with the A80. But your experience might vary. Finally, one last thing about the design of the A80, it is not IP certified in any way. So don't take this phone near water by any chance, because it has a lot of moving parts, and if it breaks, it'll cost you a lot to get this fixed. Now let's go ahead and talk about the most important and the head-turning feature of the A80, and that is this rotatable rear camera that is there at the back, and if you flip it, it's there at the front and you don't have a camera at the back. So that's pretty cool, right? So in the time that I actually used the A80, this is something a lot of people were curious to see, and a lot of people actually were quite interested in this device purely because this phone did that. So how good is the camera at the back? How good is the triple camera setup on the A80? Now let's talk about that. In my experience, the camera on a whole performed really well, but it was a hit or a miss in low light areas. So definitely the A80 is not a flagship, So it's definitely not as good as the S10 when it comes to low light, but it did a okay job when it comes to the photos. And the main thing that I loved about the A80 camera is that the rear camera is the same as the front camera. So that means you can take the same great wide angle pictures from the front facing camera of the A80 as well. And that's what I really enjoy taking with the A80. Talking about the specs of the Galaxy A80's main camera, it is a 48 megapixel camera with an aperture of f2. And it also has an 8 megapixel f2.2 snapper with an ultra wide angle lens, and along with that there is a 3D TOF sensor, a time of flight sensor with an aperture of f1.2 as well, that is used to sense the depth for better portrait pictures. Especially thanks to that third TOF sensor on the A80, Samsung doesn't only have the portrait mode, but they also have this new mode called live focus video. So it's basically live focus, which is portrait mode for videos, and that is pretty cool. Here's a sample of live focus video from the A80 so that you guys see the difference. Hey guys, so I'm here at the beach right now, and this is a live focus video camera sample from the Galaxy A80. So I just want to bring you guys a real world camera sample from the beach here. What do you guys think about all of this blur around me? So this is all thanks to the TOF camera at the back of the A80. So drop a comment down below and let me know what you guys think about the live focus video quality on the Galaxy A80. You can actually adjust the level of blur in different stages. This is the maximum level of blur that you can get with the camera of the Galaxy A80. Now let's go ahead and see some pictures from the ultra wide angle camera as well as the primary camera of the Galaxy A80 in both the rear setting as well as the front setting, that includes selfies, so that you can judge the performance of the camera of the Galaxy A80. After you see the pictures, I will tell you guys what I think about the A80 camera.
So let's bring someone who really uses this type of powerhouse for their day-to-day lives. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Sri Lanka's one of the leading English tech blogger, Andro Dollar. Hi, Andro.
Hi, how are you?
Good, how about you?
I'm doing good as well.
Yeah. So you have been using the AI device for your gamings and the other your performance and everything. So what do you think about the performance of Galaxy A80?
Yeah, so I've been using the Galaxy A80 for a few days now, and the experience has been really good. With the Snapdragon 730G processor powering the device, and with 8 gigs of RAM and 128 gigs of internal storage, has been doing good for the day-to-day activities.
So those are some of the pictures that I shot with the Galaxy A80, and none of it is actually edited. So go ahead and drop a comment down below and let me know what you guys think about the camera quality of the Galaxy A80. Oh, by the way, if you want to see how well the Galaxy A80 does when it comes to video performance, definitely go ahead and check out my latest Andro Dollar vlog. I will have it linked down below. That entire vlog was shot with the A80 itself. Every single part of it. So if I can use the A80 to shoot an entire vlog, you can see how good this phone is. But when it comes to the performance of the photos, it actually performed like a mid-ranger does. In general, the day-to-day photos were quite okay, but sometimes some photos were a bit washed out, but the colors in most of the pictures looked quite good. And it's great that this device even has the scene optimizer built in. However, I discovered something a little bit weird with the A80. That is, when you pop up the camera to take a selfie, I noticed that the camera UI doesn't have all the functionalities that you see when you're taking a photo with the rear-facing camera. I found that a little bit weird because this phone has the same camera for the back and the front. So features like night mode were missing. I have no idea why that is the case, because if it's the same camera, why not have a unified experience? No, whether you are taking a normal picture from the back or whether you are taking a selfie, that way this could definitely be the best smartphone that you're carrying for selfies, because the front facing camera is as good as the rear facing camera. In theory that should be the idea, but practically I found that some features are a bit missing. So I hope Samsung will push a software update to fix that in the near future. Let me know what you guys think about that also down below. Now that we have spoken about the camera performance of the A80, now let's go ahead and talk about the performance of the A80 and how well it actually did in the month that I used it. With the Snapdragon 730G chipset to power this and 8GB of RAM inside, the A80 did quite well when it came to the day-to-day activities. And even for gaming, this device did quite well. I really enjoyed using the A80 for gaming because this device doesn't have any type of hindrance in the screen. So that means I have the full screen to enjoy my game. No notch, no punch hole, whatever. So it's really good for gaming. So if you're looking to buy a phone for gaming, have a look at the A80 mainly because of the all screen display. Trust me, it's quite addictive once you get used to it. Now let's talk about the software on the Galaxy A80. The A80 runs on Android 9 Pie along with Samsung's One UI, and it is quite optimized for the Galaxy A80. For those of you who are used to the design language of Samsung when it comes to the software, you will definitely feel right at home when you're using the A80. And the A80 actually has a lot of great features that are packed into this device, which I even spoke about in my tips video. So definitely go ahead and check that out. I will have a link down below in the description. If you want to learn some awesome things you can do with your Galaxy device, definitely go ahead and check it out. I will have a card right here as well. If you watch a lot of videos, then the Galaxy A80 will be another great pick for you because the display on this device is quite good for that. In my testing, I found that the Galaxy A80's performance for day-to-day activities was quite okay, but if you try to pack it up and load it up with a lot of heavy things, then the phone will slow up a bit. The performance on the A80 for the price is quite okay. Now talking about the battery life on the Galaxy A80, that is something that I really enjoyed on this device. This has a 3700 mAh battery and it has 25 watt super fast charging. So this has faster charging than the Galaxy S10, Samsung's own flagship. So that is something that I really enjoyed in the time that I used this device. So I think if you are a power hungry user, you will definitely enjoy the battery life on the A80. So now what's the verdict? If you're planning to get the Galaxy A80, should you go ahead and pick it up? The Galaxy A80 is sold here in Sri Lanka for 118,990 Sri Lankan rupees, and it comes with a 2-year warranty, but because of all the mechanical parts of this phone, you have to be extra careful when you use it and make sure that you don't get any dust inside this phone. So now it's your turn to see whether the A80 is worth it for the price that it comes in for you. If it's in your budget, then definitely consider the pros and the cons and then see if it will suit your lifestyle. Because at the end of the day, you're the one who will be using the device. And if you have any questions on that, you can always contact me. All my contact details are given down below in the description. You can follow me on social media. I am at Andro Dollar. All the links are given down below in the description. So guys, with that we come to the end of this video. The A80 was a great attempt from Samsung and definitely a stepping stone for the next generation flagship coming from Samsung with an all-screen display. So it was a pleasure using this smartphone, but I'm really excited for the next iteration of this, a more perfected version of this smartphone. I hope you guys found this video helpful. If you did, definitely go here and smash that like button and hit on the subscribe button right now if you're new to my channel. And if you're not following me on social media, definitely go ahead and do so. I am at Andro Dollar. All the links are given down below in the description. And stay tuned to AndroDollar.com for the latest from the tech world. Share this video with your friends to support this channel. And until I see you guys in my next video, this is Banu signing out.